This is a 1/4-inch instrument cable, and this is a 1/4-inch speaker cable. And even though they look the same from the outside, using them interchangeably is a really terrible idea, which could create unwanted noise, or even worse, it could damage your amplifier. So in this video, I'll help you understand why. But before we get started, I want to thank the Audio University members for making this video possible without a sponsor. And I also want to offer you one of the many resources available to our members, the Cables and Connectors Guide. It'll teach you about all of the most common audio cables you need to know about as an audio engineer or musician. Download that guide for free at audiouniversityonline.com/cableguide. Both of these cables have a 1/4-inch TS connector, meaning the connectors are a 1/4-inch in diameter and have a tip and a sleeve. But beyond the connector, within the cable itself, you can see these two cables are very different. The instrument cable has a very thin insulated wire in the center, which connects to the tip of the connector. It has an electrostatic shield, which I'll talk more about in a moment, and all of this is surrounded by a stranded copper shield, which connects to the sleeve of the connector. Meanwhile, the speaker cable has two equally sized insulated conductors, just as you'd find in a typical home theater speaker wire or speaker wire with another type of connector. Neither cable is better or worse than the other. Rather, the construction of each cable is designed with a specific purpose in mind. The instrument cable connects instruments to amplifiers, DI boxes, or other input devices, while the speaker cable connects amplifiers to loudspeakers. Let's start by taking a closer look at the design of an instrument cable. When you strum a guitar, the metallic strings disrupt the magnetic field created by the pickups, and that creates a very small electrical current within the circuit. The signal coming from a passive single coil guitar pickup like this one is very low level, which makes it more susceptible to noise from surrounding electromagnetic activity compared to the signal that goes from an amplifier to a speaker. With this in mind, one key goal of an instrument cable's design is to transmit the signal across the cable without picking up too much noise along the way. To accomplish this goal, the cable is built with a coaxial configuration, where the center wire, which carries current from the pickup to the amplifier, is surrounded by a shield, which protects the center wire from noise and also acts as a return to complete the circuit. Signals from an amplifier are strong enough to power a speaker and are therefore much less susceptible to electromagnetic interference. Thus, a speaker cable doesn't have a shield, and if you use a speaker cable to connect an instrument to an amplifier, you'll likely hear a lot of noise. But don't just take my word for it. Have a listen. And this is a speaker cable. You can already hear the noise. Another consideration in the design of an instrument cable has to do with capacitance. You may have noticed that longer instrument cables will sound different compared to shorter cables. Every additional foot of cable length increases the capacitance, and this effectively places a low-pass filter on the signal, which will result in a muddy tone eventually. In addition to the cable length, the insulation material that surrounds the center conductor also plays a big role in managing capacitance between the center conductor and the shield. I made a full video on guitar cable length and capacitance that you can watch next, but there are a few more details you need to know about instrument cables and speaker cables before diving deeper into that topic. For example, the electrostatic shield within the design of an instrument cable is also very important. If this black semiconducting material wasn't here to discharge the static electricity created between the copper shield and the insulation around the center wire, we would hear crackling from movement of the cable. But with all of these technologies in place, an instrument cable can reliably preserve the tone of an instrument while allowing the musician to move around freely with minimal noise. The main purpose of a speaker cable, on the other hand, is to connect the positive and negative terminals of an amplifier to the positive and negative terminals of a loudspeaker. As I mentioned before, the signals carried from an amplifier to a loudspeaker are significantly stronger than those from an instrument to an input device. And to accommodate the higher current of a speaker level signal, the wires within speaker cables are much thicker than you'd find in instrument cables. If you didn't already know, the impedance of a conductor and the amperage or current that it can facilitate is impacted by its size. While not an entirely accurate metaphor, I find it helpful to think of a wire as a garden hose. The smaller the hose, the more resistance and the less current it can carry. In most parts of the world, the cross-sectional area of a wire is expressed in square millimeters. But as you might expect, in the US, we use a different system of wire gauge, where smaller numbers correspond to larger cross-sectional areas. Very intuitive, I know, but you'll get used to it once you work with it a little bit. While this instrument cable's center conductor is a 24 gauge wire, this speaker cable has two 14 gauge wires that are much larger. Not only are the wires thicker, offering lower impedance and greater capacity for current, but each wire also has the same impedance. This is important for the health and performance of an amp speaker circuit. I know you may be asking, what happens when I use an instrument cable as a speaker cable? You may even be saying, I've used instrument cables as speaker cables before and didn't have a problem. In fact, my high school band and I used exclusively instrument cables for years in place of speaker cables, and it worked. But just because amplifier signals can pass through an instrument cable doesn't mean you should use one for that purpose. And I do want you just to take my word for it here. I like my amplifier and I don't want to break it just for the sake of a video demonstration. When you use an instrument cable to connect an amplifier to a speaker or a cabinet, you run the risk of creating excessive heat within the cable. And if this melts the insulators within the instrument cable, there will be nothing separating the center conductor from the copper shield, creating a short between the positive and negative terminals on the amp. Ideally, your amplifier will quickly detect this and go into protection mode, but seriously, just use a speaker cable. Speaker cables contain much larger, lower gauge wires that can facilitate the transmission of these higher current signals. You'll find links to both the speaker cables and the instrument cables that I recommend in the show notes below the video. In the next video that's on your screen now, you'll hear for yourself how the length and capacitance of a guitar cable impacts the guitar tone. And of course, you'll learn why. I'll see you there.